In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, our culture is Atithi Devo Bhava, guest to be treated like God. Now slowly, this Atithi Devo Bhava is becoming Atithi Kab Jaoge, guest, when are you going back? We are known to be hospitable, but today with the changes in the modern world, we are becoming closed society, closed families, closed people. For the times we have failed to be hospitable. For the times we have failed to treat guests as gods. For the times we have failed to be respectful towards the others, to treat others as they are. For the times we have failed to see the presence of God in the other. Let us ask pardon from the Lord and let us prepare ourselves to celebrate this Eucharist in a worthy manner. Let's say together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
God and Father.
Let us pray. Let us put forth our intentions. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant that we pray that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second book of the Kings. One day, Elisha went on to Shunem, where a wealthy woman lived, who housed him to eat some food. So, whenever he passed that way, he would turn in there to eat food. And she said to her husband, "Behold, now I perceive that this is a holy man of God who is continually passing our way. Let us make a small roof chamber with walls and put there for him a bed, a table, a chair, and a lamp, so that whenever he comes to us, he can go in there." One day he came there, and he turned into the chamber and rested there. And he said, "What then is to be done for her?" Gehazi answered, "Well, she has no son, and her husband is old." He said, "Call her." And when he had called her, she stood in the doorway. And he said, "At this season, when the time comes around, you shall embrace a son." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. "Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were buried therefore with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. For we know that Christ being raised from the dead will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So, you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah, hallelujah, by the blood of Christ we stand. Every tongue, every tribe,
the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus instructed the 12 as follows. He who loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he who loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he who does not take his cross and follow me is not worthy of me. He who finds his life will lose it, and he who loses his life for my sake will find it. He who receives you receives me, and he who receives me receives him who sent me. He who receives a prophet, because he is a prophet, shall receive a prophet's reward. And he who receives a righteous man, because he is a righteous man, shall receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives to one of these little ones even a cup of cold water, because he is a disciple, truly I say to you, he shall not lose his reward. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, I began the introduction saying, Atithi Devo Bhava, guest to be treated like gods. It was indeed true, I come from a place, a small village. I remember in our childhood, whenever you are thirsty, we went in search of the water, and whichever house you entered, asking for a glass of water, the immediate response was, would you like to have buttermilk instead of water? Being the villages, being all the agriculturists, always they had cows at home, a lot of milk. So naturally, a lot of buttermilk. Instead of the water, they themselves initiated asking, would you like to have buttermilk? And we always joyfully said, yes, we do. This is how we were treating the guests, whoever it is, irrespective of religion, whether we know the person or not, always we offered what we had in abundance, out of love for the person who is pleading, who is asking for the help. Today in the Gospel, when I heard Jesus saying, even if you give a glass of cold water to the other, one of the little ones, you did it to me, or you will receive the reward from God. So this is the message in the Gospel today. Coming to the readings, in the first reading we see Elisha, a man of God, a prophet, on his mission, and a mother, a childless mother, a childless woman, sees this prophet of God, and she makes room for him in her home. She provides for his needs, only because he is a prophet, because he is a man of God. She goes out of her way, welcomes him into the house, and as a reward, she receives a son. She welcomes the prophet because he was the man of God, and she becomes the reward in the life of the prophet, And later, she receives the reward from God. It is in the first reading. In the second reading, there is another man of God. In other words, is man, Jesus Christ, God made man, comes down to us, comes down to become one like us. He was one like us, to be one with us. And there he invites us to welcome him into our lives. Here welcoming means believing in him, believing in Jesus Christ. And because of this belief, what is the reward that we have? The reward is eternal life. Again, a man of God or God made man, welcoming is believing. And for this believing, the reward that we have is eternal life. Again, a gift from God. Coming to the gospel. There they speak in three layers. A prophet, a righteous one, and a believer. In the first reading, it was prophet Elisha. In the second reading, it was Jesus Christ. And now here, there are three categories of people. Prophet, righteous one, and the believer. And if you receive the prophet, if you respect him, if you honor him, if you welcome him, you will receive the reward of a prophet. And if you welcome a righteous man because he is the righteous one, you will receive the reward of a righteous one. And if he is a believer, because he is a believer, you give him even a glass of cold water, he will receive a reward. These are the words in the gospel. Here, welcoming would mean respecting the other, honoring the other, assisting the other, helping the other. And the reward, as we heard in the gospel, God will reward you. We do not know what the reward is, but God will reward you. Anything that is done to the poor, least of the people, it will be done to God. Whatsoever you do to the least of my brethren, it is done unto me, said Jesus. Let us remember, my dear brothers and sisters, that whenever we do something good, God will reward us. Let us remember, whatever is given to God and his people is never a waste. The time, the energy that we spend for God and for God's people and for the others is never a waste. That's why they say, give to God and his people what you can, and you see, God will give to you what you cannot imagine. That happened in the life of that woman in the first reading. She was old. It was impossible, she thought. But because God blessed her womb, she had the gift of the son. Give what you have, and God gives you what you don't have. Let us give to God what we have, and certainly God will give to us what we don't have. My dear brothers and sisters, in the chain of salvation, there are four links. That's what we reflect in the gospel today. There are four links in the chain of salvation. First is God, who takes the initiative to save his people. He sends his son, Jesus Christ. Jesus becomes one like us. He is the second link in this chain. And third one, he sends his disciples after proclaiming the good news. So, and third link is the human person, the disciples, the apostles. And the fourth link is the believer. Everyone is important. Everyone is to be respected because he's the believer. All these four links are important. We need to respect them. We need to honor them. We need to help them whenever it is possible. Because there is some element of God in each one of us. All of us. All of us have that element of God, that grace of God in us, because we believe in the Lord. Because we follow the commands of the Lord. Today, in the first part of the gospel, we say, you're not worthy of me if you honor your father and mother more than me. How to understand this aspect? God does not say you hate your parents. God does not say you hate your father and mother, brother and sister. No. God says what is important in your life is give first place to God. Parents are given us birth, certainly. They deserve that prominent place. But God is the creator. God has created in his own image and likeness. That's what God says. Give the first place to God. If you honor your father and mother, devoid of God, maybe we may be able to do good things to the parents. You respect God, give first place to God, and respect parents, maybe you are doing better things to your parents. You respect God, give first place to God, pray to God for your parents, then you'll be doing the best things for your parents, for our parents. This is what the meaning of the gospel, you are not worthy of me when you give first place to your parents. God wants us to give first place to God, and with the grace of God, we are able to treat everyone, even our father and mother, in a better manner. My dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, I would like to thank you today for making our place, wherever we are, a home. Now, almost 20 years, I left my home, left my father and mother and a brother. 20 years, I have been out of the house, and wherever I was, wherever I am, I feel I am at home because of your love. You make us feel that we are your own. You make us feel that we belong to you. You belong to us. You make us feel this is our home. That's why we are able to work wholeheartedly, because of your love, because of your support, because of your encouragement. We are able to do so much here in our monastery, even in this difficult situation of Corona. We have been able to do so much. It's because of your love, because of your support, because of your encouragement. You have been always with us. Because we are men of God, you have been always respectful towards us. You respect us. You help us. You assist us. You encourage us. Thank you personally in a very special way. Thank you today as we reflect this gospel. Whatever you do to the representatives of God, God will reward you. God will reward you abundantly. Certainly, you have been our reward. In various ways, you have been instruments of God's love for us. God has spoken to us through you. God has been a reward to us through you, and we have tried to do our best so that we can be a reward in your life. So thank you once again for all the wonderful things that you do for us, for your love. Many of you, because of your love, because of your guidance, you have been like a father figure in our lives. Many of you have been very motherly in guiding us, in loving us, in showing care and concern. So many of you are like our brothers and sisters, accompanying us in our life's journey, making our life more memorable one, a joyful one. And when we falter, treat us like your son and daughters, like your brothers and sisters. We are human beings. We falter at times. We fall. Lift us up. Whisper in our ears something that is going wrong so that we are able to come back to the track. If need be, slap us on our face in private, so that we can come back to the track, come back to the track, walk on the right path, instead of treating us like the third person and speaking ill of us, spoiling our name, maligning our name in public. I think if you treat us like your brothers and sisters, if you treat us like your own, your sons and daughters, we'll be able to do better. We'll be able to come back to the right way, right path. We'll be able to do more and more for the greater glory of God. Today, as we reflect this gospel, let us try to be more and more hospitable. Let us be smiling. Let us be happy. Let us be gentle in our words. All of us deserve respect. All of us who believe in God deserve that respect. Jesus says, all those who are believers, they deserve the respect from us because they believe in God. God loves them and they love God. Let not our words be, why did you come? Let us be saying, please come. Let us not say, why did you call today? Let us say, I am free, please call me. Let us be more and more hospitable. Let not our gates say, beware of dogs, please don't enter. Let us say, be aware of the human beings who are here, who are gentle, so smiling. Let not our surveillance cameras be blocking someone to enter our house, but those cameras show us the needs of the others who are around us. Those intruding alarms may not block the other from coming in, but let it allow us to go out of ourselves so that we are able to reach out to the need of the other. To be Christian is to give. To be Christian is to give. The Lord has given us so much of love He has poured on us. And I said, whatever we give, we never lose. We never lose. The time and the energy and the money that we spend on God and others will never be a waste. We will be rewarded abundantly. And many of us feel these days in this situation, difficult situation of Corona, so much of good that we are doing, so much of good that we are doing. I think none of us are suffering. We have been rewarded. We have been rewarded by God. We enjoy that peace. We enjoy that serenity, the gift from the Lord. There are two types of people, they say. The first category appreciates the good that is done. They appreciate, they clap, they say, well done, you have done well. And there's another category of people who condemn. What you have done is wrong. It should have been done this way. And you ask them what they do nothing. Either they appreciate or they condemn. But we, let us take a bold step. Let us go one step ahead. We are Christians. We are called to do something concretely. And not just to appreciate, or just to condemn. Let us try to do what we can. A little that we can. It is said, the Japanese say, if he and she can do, I too can do. If he and she cannot do, if he and she cannot do, I must do. This is what the Japanese believe, it seems. Coming to the Indians, if he and she can do, let him do, let her do. And if he and she cannot do, how can I do? So this is our attitude. So let us not be like that. Let us do what we can. What Jesus asks is just to give a glass of cold water. Nothing more. Jesus does not ask to give something more. When the person is in need, when he's thirsty, a glass of cold water. Very little the Lord expects from us as we are here around this altar. Where Jesus gives himself completely to us. Where he teaches us what is that giving. Let us learn the art of giving. Let us learn the art of respecting the other. Let us learn the art of loving the other. Let us respect everyone because each and everyone is created in the image and likeness of God. May the Lord inspire us. May the Lord guide us. May the Lord teach us how to love. Amen. Let us profess our faith in the triune God. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our God is a loving God. He is here and now. He is present amidst us. With this faith, let us put forth our intentions before the Lord.
Lord, show us your kindness.
Lord, show us your kindness.
For the Pope, the bishops, the clergy, and the religious, that as leaders of the Church, they may work towards the advancement of the Kingdom of God and its values. Lord, show us your kindness. For Christians all over the world, that following Jesus, the Master, they may become examples of love and fellowship. Lord, show us your kindness. That childbearing and motherhood may become a happy experience in the lives of all the mothers and that they may be specially blessed for the sacrifice they make. Lord, show us your kindness. For childless couples who, in spite of their strong desire to bring forth a child and nurture it in the Christian faith, are denied this possibility, they may experience joy and satisfaction in their lives. Lord, show us your kindness. For all children, that in their infancy, which is a crucial period in the overall development of their personality, they may receive adequate parental care and guidance. Lord, show us your kindness. Let us put forth our personal petitions.
Lord, show us your kindness to be more and more hospitable, loving, gentle in our words and deeds. Help us, Lord, to accept everyone as they are, and to see your presence in each and every person we meet, and respect them because they are your creation. Respect them because you dwell in them. Help us, Lord, to grow in this faith. Help us to love as you loved each and everyone. We make this prayer to you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that the sacrifice you and me offer here on this altar may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy Church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the days by which we serve you may be worthy of this sacred gift. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the hosts of angels adores your majesty, and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord,
you are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Philip Neri our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, a chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Asking for the grace to respect everyone as they are, accept everyone as they are, let us recite the prayer taught by Jesus himself. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit."
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you all.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Behold who invites us to become a reward in the life of the other so that he can become a reward in our lives. Happy are we who are called to the supper of this Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads for God's blessings. May Almighty God bless you in His kindness and pour out saving wisdom upon you. Amen.
Amen.
May He nourish you always with the teachings of the faith and make you persevere in holy deeds.
Amen.
May He turn your steps towards Himself and show you the path of charity and peace.
Amen.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you once again for everything that you do for us, and have a nice day. Music.